Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's episode, I want to show you guys how we got this image using this mirror. So let's jump straight into it. If you guys are subscribed to our channel, you saw last week that we posted a video about going to the sand dunes and doing a photo shoot with John, Chris, and Roxy. And one technique that we used while we were out there is using this mirror in front of our lens, or rather underneath the lens, I'm going to show you guys exactly where, to reflect the clouds from the sky onto the bottom of our image. So the technique is actually very simple. It could actually also be done with your cell phone, but there are a few key things that you guys need to remember that I'm going to go into so it can make your life a little bit easier. So when I first saw this technique, I thought that you had to put the mirror underneath the camera like this in order to get the reflection on the bottom, because that's what it looks like. Actually, the way that you place it is very different. You actually have to place the mirror somewhere in the middle. So instead of placing it on the bottom, and that I remember I was having so many problems trying to get this technique to work. When you put it on the bottom, you can't really get the angle right. When you put it somewhere in the middle and then start tilting around, you're able to reflect the sky into the bottom of the frame. Now, there are several things that I want to get into. One, the size of the mirror. So when I first started doing this, I was using this little guy. And this thing, I mean, it works, but I felt like a lot of the times I was getting on the edges, it wasn't really reflecting, and it was kind of annoying. Now, I know now with generative AI, it's pretty easy. Do some generative fill on the sides and you're good to go. So you could get away with that. However, I'm from the school of thought that I would rather get it right in camera. So I opted for the larger mirror. If I ever get pulled over, I'm definitely gonna have to explain myself why I have mirrors everywhere that look like I'm ready to party. But that is not the case. This is for this technique. And you can get these things on Amazon. They're literally shaving mirrors. I'll leave the link below so you guys can check it out. And a few other tips as far as how to achieve this look is, you don't want to do it with a clear blue sky. Like a really clear, bright blue sky is just going to blind you, because you're going to tilt the sun right into your eyeballs, or into the sensor, really. And you don't want to be cooking that thing. So we usually only do it with overcast days. I'm showing you guys a few examples right now where it's going to reflect a really, really cool sky. And it's going to look like the couple or your subject is sitting in the clouds. So in this specific situation, it was a little bit overcast, so I knew that we were gonna be able to get that. It wasn't just gonna look white and blown out on the bottom. I did, however, also use the MagMod XL with the MagSphere, the large one, obviously, camera left, and that way I can bring my subject out of the background. Because if I shot it like that without any flashes, it would simply make our couple disappear into the background. It would be a silhouette. It could be a very cool silhouette, but that's not the look that I was going for on this one. I did leave the flash in the frame because of the angle of where it was, and I didn't want my assistant holding it, and I just figured, you know what, it's easier just to Photoshop it out anyway. And as you're seeing in the original image, I was also gonna add a little sliver on the bottom just to add a little bit more reflection so it really looks like they're sitting on clouds. You're never gonna get it perfect, and to me, I would rather get where I still get their feet in the frame, and then I can kind of later on add exactly where I want it to end, instead of cutting their feet and then later on going, damn, like I cut their ankles. You know what I mean? So I always like to have a little bit of leeway, so that way later on I can always perfect it and get it exactly where I want. So as far as some technical numbers, we were at ISO 400 on it. We were on the Tamron 35-150, which is my favorite freaking lens. We have a few videos about it. I'll link them down below. Definitely check that out. And it was at 2.8 because I wanted it to be soft, in case I didn't want to add additional mirror on the bottom, additional sky on the bottom. I want that soft fall off. If you go to like f8, f11, anything like that, it's going to be very sharp. It's not necessarily what you would want to do, because you want kind of that dreamy kind of effect. That's another reason why if I were to do this in the middle of the day, I probably would use high speed sync in order to keep my aperture nice and wide, so it's nice and soft. Again, there's also another video that we posted on high speed sync. Go ahead and check that out if you guys are curious to learn about high speed sync, because it's a whole thing. The shutter speed was 1/2000th of a second, and that's because, again, we wanted to keep our aperture nice and low, so that way it's nice and fuzzy on the bottom, so it looks like a little dreamy effect and not super, super sharp. And then I'll show you guys here the before and after, how we did a little bit of post-production. I did cool it down a little bit. I don't know, that's personal taste. You guys, You guys, you know, when you edit, you can add your own flair. I liked a little bit of the blue highlights to contrast the orange on their skin, the tanness on their skin. So that's what I went with. But yeah, there's a cool technique. I remember years ago using prisms was in. And I think, you know, some people still do it. And I think it can be done very tastefully still. Is this something that's going to come and go? And, you know, maybe, who knows? But it's not like I shot the entire day like this. You know what I mean? This is a shot that we do to pepper in a little bit of something different, something funky, along with all the other staple shots that we do. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please let me know, guys. Leave a comment below. Keep it respectful. Let's build a community here. And I'll be posting another one in the next few days. Thank you so much for watching.